Turn to textbook page 126, conversation 2. We are going to practice reading and also we are going to go over the contents. 리사 씨, 아파트에 방이 몇개 있어요? 아파트에 방이 몇개 있어요? Lisa, how many rooms are there in your apartment? 세개 있어요. 세개 있어요. There are three rooms. Roommate 있어요? Do you have any roommate? 네. 두명 있어요. Yes, we have two. 룸메이트도 학생이에요? 룸메이트도 학생이에요? 네, 제니하고 유미는 생물학을 공부해요. Yes, Jenny and Yumi both are roommates. They both are majoring in or studying in 생물학, which is biology. 그리고 제니는 제 한국어 반 친구예요. And Jenny is my classmate in Korean. 룸메이트들하고 사이가 좋아요? 룸메이트들하고 사이가 좋아요? 사이가 좋다 means having a good relation or get along well. So 사이가 좋아요 here means is your relationship with your roommates good? 네, 사이가 아주 좋아요. Meaning we have a good relations or we get along well. 이건 누구 방이에요? Whose room is this? 이건 누구 방이에요? 제 방이에요. This is my room. 방이 참 예뻐요. 고마워요. Okay, now based on the conversation 2, please answer. 아파트에 방이 몇 개 있어요? 세 개 있어요. There are three rooms. 룸메이트 있어요? 네, 있어요. 룸메이트 몇명 있어요? How many roommates are there? 두 명 있어요. 룸메이트도 학생이에요? 네, 룸메이트도 학생이에요. 룸메이트하고 사이가 아주 좋아요? 네, 사이가 좋아요. 이건 누구 방이에요? 이건 제 방이에요. This is my room. 제 방이에요. Okay. Now I'm just going to ask you a question based on your current situation. You may answer. 집에 or 아파트에 방이 몇개 있어요? We can say 방이 두개 있어요. or 세개 있어요. 룸메이트 있어요? 네, 있어요. If you have one. Or if you don't. 네, 아니요, 없어요. No, I don't. 아니요, 없어요. 룸메이트 몇 명이에요? 룸메이트 몇 명이에요? You can say 두 명이에요. I have two roommates. Or 룸메이트 한 명이에요. I have one roommate. 룸메이트하고 사이가 좋아요? Do you get along well with your roommate? 가족들하고 사이가 좋아요? Okay. 자, let's review new words on textbook page 127. It's pronounced 거 usually or 것. So the difference between these two are the first one is a shortened form, more like used in daily conversation. 것 is a full form, so preferred in written mode, meaning thing. So this is a defective noun. It cannot stand by itself. Always combine some kind of expression like 이거, meaning this thing. 이 means this, 이거, or 그거, that thing. 누나, what is 누나? 누나 is the older sister of male, 누나. 언니 is the older sister of female, 언니, 언니. But that can be extended in other contexts as well. So in Korea, if you cannot find the appropriate calling terms, you can use this expression, a calling term to call anyone who's about a few years older than you. 언니, 언니. Roommate is roommate. 방, room. 사이, 사이 has two meanings. One is relationship. 사이가 좋아요. Having a good relationship. Or get along well. Or between. 사이, 사이. 생물학 is biology. Apartment is apartment. Apartment is shortened form in Korean. 아파트, 아파트. 뉴욕, 로스앤젤레스, 하와이. 네. 자, what is 고맙다? To be thankful, this is an adjective. And it is conjugated as 고마워요. So whenever you try to express your gratitude to someone, you can use this expression. 고마워요. 고마워요. 나쁘다, to be bad, and this is the opposite, 좋다, to be good. 나, and it's conjugated as 나빠요. 나빠요, 좋아요. 좋아요. 비싸다, 싸다, to be expensive and cheap. 비싸다, 싸다. 작다, 크다, to be small, to be big. 작다, 크다, 작다, 크다. 배우다. This is a verb meaning to learn something. I am learning piano. 피아노 배워요. I'm learning Korean. 한국어 배워요. 배우다. 오다. To come. It'll conjugate as 와요. 와요. To sleep. 자다. It's conjugate as 자요. 자요. To give something. 주다. 주어요 or 줘요. 줘요. And this is the possessive pronoun and plural form. 우리 and 저희. 우리, 저희. This is a possessive pronoun meaning my or mine. 내 or 제. The difference between 내 and 제 is a humble form. 내 is a plain form. So depending on the addressee, you have to choose the correct form. If someone is honored person or a respected person or senior person, choose the humble form, which is 제. 제. Okay, that's it.